Victorian motorists are being slugged by the second at speed and red light cameras across the state, with some calling it highway robbery. Exclusive government documents reveal just how much we're paying. Laura Turner joins me live with the details. Laura, these really are quite startling figures.
Good evening, Pete. Yes, they are. Motorists are paying tens of millions of dollars in speed and red light camera fines. We lodged a Freedom of Information request for these figures and have been waiting 6 months for them to be released. When we finally received the documents, there were pages and pages of detail on exactly where we're being stung and by how much. Some arguing it is for all the wrong reasons. A day in the life of an almost $9 million asset. Some, the cameras are not flashing danger signs, but dollar signs.
It's just a rolling money box. I've called them piggy banks on poles.
Freedom of Information documents revealing Victorians paid $86 million in mobile speed camera fines in a 12-month period and $140 million for red light camera infringements. Motorists we spoke to call it highway robbery.
I think they're revenue raisers, really. I think if they were safe for safety, then they would be more visible.
Are they there to save your life or take your money?
I think take your money, but that's my opinion.
Ballarat Road Footscray brought in $1.1 million. The Great Ocean Road just over $1 million. And Huntingdale Road, Station Street and Beaconsfield Parade were next. The red light camera at King Street slugged motorists $8.7 million. Warrigal Road, Chadstone, $8.2 million. Fitzroy Street, St Kilda, Flinders Street and Geelong Road Footscray were the next top earners. At this King Street intersection in Melbourne West, motorists were nabbed more than 35,000 times in the 12-month period, and that's just for red light infringements alone. The state government says every dollar raised goes to road safety and camera locations are decided by police and crash data. But anti-traffic camera crusader John King says we should be sceptical about their purpose.
We don't have any independent people to check the accuracy of these cameras.
The state opposition says it would police the cameras as well as motorists.
We think there should be more independence put into the location of speed cameras. Victorian motorists need to know the cameras should be put in the places that will save lives, not raise Daniel Andrews the most money.
Laura Turner, Nine News.